Well, praise the Lord. It's really good to be here today. I just want to take a reading from the Bible, and it's taken from Luke chapter 4, verse 1. Then Jesus, being filled with the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being tempted for 40 days by the devil. And in those days he ate nothing, and afterward, when they had ended, he was hungry. So we don't really know what happened in the wilderness there. But a lot happened, and so much happened there. If you were to meditate on it, you could come up with all kinds of things, what Jesus accomplished in the wilderness when he was alone there in the wilderness and he was tempted by the devil, and what happened there, and the warfare that was going on in that desert. But it was all for a purpose. He had been baptized by John the Anointed. The power of the Spirit came upon him. He was led by the Spirit, and he overcame in that wilderness. He was fasting, and then at the end of the fast, a stronger temptation. He had actual personal confrontation of the devil with a massive, powerful vision of the devil tempting him with all these things you can read about in that chapter. But then after that, he came out in the power of the Spirit, and that was the beginning, the very outset of his miracles. Then miracle ministry started. And there's power in fasting. And Jesus is a prime example of a person who would fast. You know, he came down from heaven. And as a man, he depended on the power of the Holy Spirit. And he was tempted at all points like we are, yet without sin. He overcame. And he obviously overcame a lot through his fasting and prayer. And so here's an example for us today. And there's a purpose in fasting. Personally, I myself have fasted many times in my life. One-day fast. I've had three-day fasts. I remember once I had a three-day fast without food and water. Now, I wouldn't recommend that to anybody, having a fast without food and water. But at that time, I was a young Christian. I was quite ignorant of things. So I did it, yeah, and I went through quite a lot in doing it. But it was for a purpose, because this woman who was demon-possessed, she was playing with a Ouija board, and a lot of things happened there. She was possessed by a very, very powerful spirit, and she needed deliverance. And so I felt I had to fast for her, and she did get delivered in the end, but not without a major battle. And the next time I fasted for 3 days was with just water. I had water, so that was wiser. And then over the years, it's been one day fast. But ever since then, for many years now, I've always fasted on Sundays, till midday, because I have always believed that I should minister with on an empty stomach, and because I needed the anointing. And that's really what I'm speaking about today. If you want to increase the anointing in your life, you might already be you're saved, you're baptized with the Holy Spirit, but you really want to increase the anointing on your life for your ministry, or to understand the purpose of God in your life, and you want clarity of thought to know where you're going, and you really want to show God you mean business, then fasting is a perfect way to do it. And I've done this for years, and I've always found it's a lot easier to minister when I'm fasting. And at midday, you know, after I've ministered and that, we'll have a biscuit, cup of tea, and have lunch later. But it's something I've got into, I'm used to now, and I can see the results of it. It's awesome, it's powerful. And so I would encourage you today, if you're seeking something from God in your life, to spend time fasting, and things will start to take place, things will start to happen for you, and miracles will start to flow. Your faith is quickened, and through fasting, and you're moving into a spiritual experience, a spiritual world. And sometimes things cannot come out but by prayer and fasting. If you want to overcome the devil, something that's strongholds in your life, and there's things against you, then you need to fast. So I encourage you to do that today. Thank you for listening.